Well, the competition is fierce, and in many real estate markets, it is a seller's market, and there are a ton of buyers all competing for the same properties. With that said, in this video, I'm gonna provide you guys some helpful tips if you guys are making a bid on properties, and also certain things to be aware of. If you guys are new to my channel, my name is Steve, and I'm a Florida real estate broker as well as investor. Now, having lived through the last real estate recession, we've experienced something very comparable to today's market. Now, just a word of a caution, be sure you guys speak to the appropriate professionals in your area, in your state regarding any of these real estate matters, and whether that's a local real estate agent or a real estate attorney. This video is made for informational purposes only, and there are certain risks associated with these strategies. With that said, let's dive into some ways that you can have a competitive advantage when making your offer. The first thing and the most obvious is submitting an offer over asking price. Now, there are two areas that I have to caution you in doing so. The first is make sure if you guys are going to bid over asking price and pay top dollar for the property, be sure that you guys intend in staying in this property for years to come. And I'm talking maybe 5 to 10 years, because you never know what's gonna happen with the real estate market. And 2 years down the road, even if the market flattens out or even decreases a little bit, you may be in an upside down position based on how much money you put down on the property and maybe how much improvement you've done. I'll put a link below as well where I broke down a simple scenario of this happening in a 2 year period where the market nominally decreased in value, where somebody would actually have to come to the table with over $30,000 to sell their property, and that's the last thing that you guys want to get into. Now, the second thing, assuming you guys are financing, and a word of caution is you still have to deal with an appraisal. Now, an appraiser is gonna search all the recent sold comps as well as look at the active market of available inventory, and they're gonna make their decision. And if you guys are basically coming in at a price that's way too high, it might not appraise, and then you're gonna run into a situation where you're gonna have to either renegotiate with the seller, maybe meet halfway if you have the additional funds to offset the appraisal. And in some cases, some sellers may not budge. And if you want the property that bad, then you might have to come to the table with that spread. And now that brings me into my next competitive advantage is I have seen some people do this. Again, I'm not the biggest fan of doing something like this, but they actually put it in the contract that if it does not appraise, that they will pay additionally for that spread up to a certain amount. Again, they're gonna be overpaying fair market value for that property in most cases in that scenario, but that will give buyers a competitive advantage. The next way to have a competitive advantage when making an offer on a home is a larger deposit, escrow deposit. Now, another word of caution on this as well is, anytime you're putting money into escrow, most cases there is a certain level of vulnerability for that escrow. Even if your contract says you have certain contingencies where you could get that escrow back, it doesn't necessarily mean a seller is willing to sign off on a release and cancellation in the state of Florida anyway. And again, speak to an attorney in your state about this. Now, if you guys are putting a larger escrow deposit, you may want to consider putting a nominal amount at the time of actually being executed. And then after, say, the inspection period, a successful inspection period, then you're gonna put maybe a second deposit to basically beef up your competitive advantage for your offer. The next thing is, if you guys are financing, do yourself a favor as well as everybody else. And this is, you know, it's gonna help your offer, but you guys should do this anyway. Instead of getting a pre-approval letter, get a full-on approval from the lender, subject to basically the property that you choose. Now, what do I mean by that? A pre-approval letter really doesn't mean much. I can get a pre-approval letter within 5 minutes, basically telling a mortgage broker basically what I think my credit is and how much money I make. They'll issue a pre-approval letter. Now, what you could do and have a competitive advantage and have your real estate agent explain this in the offer as well, that you guys are fully approved, meaning you went through the application process with the lender, you submitted all your tax returns, you submitted bank statements, you submitted pay stubs, you submitted everything, your credit was pulled, everything is basically done, and it's basically subject to getting the property and getting the right property into contract. The next thing to have a competitive advantage is to basically make your offer with your contingencies very quickly. So most notable, most contracts, you're gonna have basically an inspection contingency and you're gonna have a financing contingency. So if you could reduce those timelines, that is gonna show, that's gonna incentivize the seller to look at your offer a little bit more thoroughly, because you guys are gonna get out of those inspection periods, you're gonna get out of that financing contingency period, and then eventually your escrow could become jeopardized and vulnerable. The next thing to strengthen your offer is to go in with actually no financing contingencies. A lot of contracts will allow you guys to put in there you're gonna pay cash, but in some cases it says will still obtain a loan. That's how the Florida state contract is. Again, check with your real estate agent, check with your attorney on that language. But basically, I don't suggest anybody do this unless you can, you have the ability to actually pay cash at closing in case something gets f***ed up, or you're just very confident in your financial capability to obtain that loan. The next thing is no inspection contingency. I don't recommend this for majority of people unless maybe you're a savvy contractor, you thoroughly went through the property already. I've done this in the past and it's been very successful because the escrow money, the $10,000 that I put on the line, is immediately non-refundable going into contract. So you kind of need to know what you're walking into. If you're just a traditional buyer, I don't recommend this at all. But having a 0-day contingency period for inspection can make the seller look at your offer very closely. The next thing, if you guys are making an offer and you have a real estate agent representing you on the buy side, have that real estate agent call the other realtor and ask what the seller prefers in terms of a closing date. Some sellers might be super motivated and they need to get out as quickly as possible and they want a fast close date. And then other sellers wanna take their time because maybe they've lived there for a long time, they gotta pack all their stuff, and they might need 2 months, 3 months, whatever the case is. So I suggest being very flexible with the close date. Have your realtor call the listing agent and figure out what that prime close date is or around that date, and work with what you got there. And speaking of real estate agents, assuming you're not going directly to the owner or the listing agent and you have a realtor that's representing you, be sure when you are creating that offer that that real estate agent actually highlights all the advantages of going with your offer. Look, a lot of real estate agents, listing agents, they can be lazy at times and they don't necessarily want to take the time to review every contract over and over and over, especially if there's a lot of offers. In some cases, you're going to see places where they have 20, 30, 40 offers, which is insane. So you want to make sure that your real estate agent in the email is breaking down why this offer is so solid with a combination of things that we just spoke about. The next thing is be sure you guys remain calm and anticipate that you might not get the property. I would just try to take as much emotion out of this process as possible because it's only gonna hurt you guys, and you guys can get very frustrated, especially if you're losing out on multiple houses. I understand it can be a frustrating process, but all you can do is remain unemotional and remain calm. And the last tip that I got for you guys is be sure that you guys have Plan B, Plan C, Plan D, Plan E, Plan Z. Make sure you have multiple options outside of just that property. Get creative. Maybe you guys don't need the fourth bedroom or the pool and you can actually install a pool or whatever the case is. Be sure you guys are getting creative and compromising your needs versus your wants, and open up your portal of properties in that sense, because inventory is slim right now, and if you guys don't get creative and don't open up the portal of inventory, it could just hurt your chance of getting a property in this market. So prime example, we had an investor or a buyer, for a first time home buyer, and he needed a fourth bedroom, but there where he was looking and his price range, it was slim to none. So we started to look at properties that were just larger in size. They were 3-bedroom, 2-bathroom, but they had the size where we had to figure out the floor plan if he could actually add a fourth bedroom to it. And that's what we're working on with that guy right now. And it's just a way to open up more inventory to choose from. Be sure you guys watch this next video on somebody buying a property that could be potentially upside down, because you do not want to overpay for a property where you got to sell sooner than later in a 2-year period if something happens with the market. So be sure you guys watch that video because I break it all down for you, and I'll see you guys on that one. Thanks a lot.